So to tell you more about the conference and welcome you all, I invite Professor Najmul Hassan to come and welcome you all. Please, sir.
Respected dignitaries on the dais, Professor Ram Sagar, our keynote speaker and our chief guest, Dr. Sikandar, our registrar, Dr. Aleem Basha, head Department of Physics, convener of the conference, Dr. Priya Hassan, and Dr. Rizwan, my dear colleagues, the delegates, and all those who've come from far and wide. I welcome you all for this conference. This four-day conference, we hope, will be a tight-packed one, where especially the students should go home with a lot of enthusiasm to get involved into studying star clusters. Astronomy begins with stars, and stars are never born alone. They are born in groups or clusters. And we are living at a very interesting time when there are various surveys which are mapping the sky. And recently we have Gaia, which is going to map, 1 billion stars, 1% of our Milky Way galaxy, and with phenomenal accuracy and precision. It's going to have kinematical data, it would have photographic and very good astrometry. So this is a very interesting time to be studying star clusters. And we are very fortunate to have with us Professor Ram Sagar. I can very confidently say that at least all the Indian audience here who has worked on star clusters at any moment of time are doing research are directly or indirectly trained by him. Either he has trained them directly or they are trained by people whom he had trained. So we are very fortunate to have him with us. And I'm sure you'll learn a lot from this thing. I will not take too much of your time. And I wish the conference a big success. I hope you are comfortable in Manu. We have a good campus, good air to breathe, and environment-friendly one. And be safe and be happier. Any issues, do come to us. We are there to solve them. All the best.
Thank you, sir. Friends, we are indeed honored to have amidst us Professor Ram Sagar, an eminent scientist. He's the person responsible for setting up India's most powerful and largest telescope.
Respected dignitaries on the dais and off the dais, teaching and non-teaching fraternity of MANUU, participants, guests, and my dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you. We are honored this morning with the presence of our beloved registrar, Dr. M.A. Sikandar Sahab, and our chief guest, Professor Ram Sagar Ji, who is a senior scientist from Indian Institute of Astrophysics, Bangalore. It gives me an immense pleasure to introduce our speaker, Professor Ram Sagar Ji. He did his master degree in 1973 and PhD in 1981 from University of Gorakhpur. He bags numerous awards and special attainments. After his education, he served many Indian institutions in various capacities. He is the founder director of ARIS, that is Aryabhatta Research Institute of Observational Sciences at Nainital. He played instrumental role in converting that 50-year-old state observatory under UP and Uttarakhand state government into autonomous research institute as ARIS under Department of Science and Technology, Government of India. He also played a key role in establishing, as our assistant professor told, okay, the India's largest telescope and world-class observational facilities, namely the 3.6 meter and 4 meter optical telescope at Nainital. His research fields includes star clusters, variable stars, microlensing events, and aerosol contents in the Earth's atmosphere. Professor Ram Sagar has supervised and guided 18 PhDs with approximately 400 research publications and over 62,000 citations. He was chief editor for the Journal of Astrophysics and Astronomy for the last 5 years. And presently, he is associate editor of Journals for Indian Academy of Sciences. So now I request and invite our chief guest, Professor Ram Sagar ji, to enlighten over this thing. And I would like to invite with the Mir Taqi Mir Sher, ke phool gul shams o khamar sare hi the. Phool gul shams o khamar sare hi the, par hami in mein tumhi bahut bhai. Now I request Professor Ram Sagar ji with a huge round of applause. Thank you.
You know, dignitaries sitting on the dais, particularly Rajasthan Sahib Sikandar and you know, other distinguished people, my colleagues and you know, audience who is present here, mostly I'm happy to see that young people are sitting here. And as you will see across this conference, it's very useful for you people. I can just briefly tell you that during last four decades, as you heard, I completed my master degree more than 40 years ago. And whatever, you know, we started in this field, this is very important field. And today, where are we? In fact, I'm very happy that Dr. Priya Hassan, she has taken this initiative to organize this conference so that you know what is happening as of today, in a sense, in the field, and how exciting it is. In fact, if you will learn during the process that what are its importance. Like it's a tool, we call it, you know, generally we try to understand, as you heard just in the prayer even, how sun was formed, our solar system is formed. So this is one of the basic thing that we always ask, how universe was formed. In that, the second question immediately comes, how our solar system was formed. And we know sun is one of the stars. And today's, during last 15 years, if you ask me, what are the major discoveries in this field? So this is one of the major discovery. That question, which we were, you know, if you read our, you know, religious book or older books, there is always question, are we alone in the universe? Kya hum log akele hai ya koi aur bhi hai? You know, this basic question was always asked. And theoretically, when people were trying to understand it, then, you know, science is a systematic knowledge. You know, step by step, you try to understand. So if you are able to understand how solar system was formed, it's a basis of some, you know, theoretical assumption and then observational proof, then it was a question, even when people formed the solar nebula theory, what we call it, that how our solar system was formed, this was always a question that why we should be alone. And that important question during last one decade, it has been clearly answered that, yes, it is true, we are not alone. There are many solar systems, what now called, it's a new field which is coming up. And why it is exciting? Because they have provided observational constraints, you know, on the our understanding of star formation, or ultimately you can say how our universe was formed. So these questions are very linked, and they are very important, which you will definitely, you know, learn during this process of this conference. So I would like to congratulate the convener of this conference and other dignitaries who are sitting here for supporting this, I will say, very important event, as well as IUCA, I mean, who is really always, you know, it's Inter University Center for Astronomy and Astrophysics, and they are in fact contributing a lot to the growth of astronomy, particularly in university sector. And many more things you will learn. So I would like to conclude my this brief presentation to you, that this topic is very important, and it's very, I will say, timely. If you are going to have anything to do with modern astrophysics, and as our Dean School of Science, he mentioned, Professor Hassan, that Gaia, that the latest data archive which has come, and I'm happy that many things are going to happen. You will see how exciting results are there and how you can make best use of it. Thank you.